Let us start the third problem. So the question is, you are supplied with the following data respect of Manoj Limited for ensuing year. The productions for the year is 69,000 units. So the raw material in stores 2 months, credit allowed by creditors 2 months, selling price rupees 50, direct wages 10% of SP means selling price. Next, finished goods in stores 3 months, production process. So the production process is nothing but it is work in progress. So 1 month, credit allowed to debtors 3 months, and raw materials 50% of SP and overheads 20% of SP. Okay, there is a regular production and sales cycle, and wages and overheads accrue evenly. Wages are paid in the next month of accrual. A material is introduced in the beginning of the production cycle. You are required to prepare a statement showing the working capital. Okay, so how we previously solved the our work in progress. Similarly, so here also we need to calculate. So the work in progress, finished goods, and the raw materials in case of our current assets. So later on we should take as the same steps which we take under the previous problem. But here I have come up with a new method. Okay, so if you have the same units of the production. Okay, so what is that? So let us see with the work in progress. Okay, the work in progress, so here is having the working note 1 is showing the calculation of the cost of, sorry, it is not cost, so the calculation of selling price of the work in progress. So in the previous method what we have calculated, just I will show you. So in the work in progress, finished goods separately, material, labor, overhead we took, right? So here also you can see. So to avoid these three steps, I am going to take the only one price. Okay, so what is the one price? So how you should calculate that one, let us see in this working note. Okay, the raw material cost of unit is how much? So here let me go for the problem. So it is raw material cost of the unit is how much? It is 50% of SP. Okay, so what is the selling price? It is 50. Okay, 50 into 50 divided by 100, so I will get the rupees 25. Similarly, the labor cost of the unit is, so that is the direct wages, so it is 10% of SP, that is, so how much is the SP? It is 50 rupees, 10% means, so I will get the 5 rupees. Similarly, the overhead has the 20% of SP, that is 50 rupees multiplied into 20%, I will get the 10 rupees. Okay, what is my answer now? 25, 5 plus 10. So I remained with the total value of rupees 40. Okay, this I am going to take in a one step only. So I am not going to take as previously we solved the three steps in case of work in progress and the finished goods. So I am not taking that one. Directly I am taking so 69,000 units given multiplied into 40. Okay, that will give you a less number of steps while calculating the problem. Now let us go for the problem. So that is, already I wrote the model. Calculation of working capital equals to the particulars and the amount. So amount is in rupees. So the two columns are there. The first one is current assets. The current assets holds the opening inventories. So that is raw material, production process, and finished goods. So the raw material is how much? Let me see. So what is the number of productions units? It is 69,000. So the 69,000 multiplied into, so what is the my raw material price? So it is 50% of SP, means here you can see it is 25 rupees. Okay, it is 25 rupees. So multiplied into, So directly I will go for the 2 months. Okay, in this problem they didn't given the any of the calculation that you should go for the weekly or monthly basis. So whatever they have given, that we are going to just take it. So all the credit period you can see that they are in the months. Okay, so the 2 months, the raw materials in stores is 2 months, means 2 divided by 12 I am going to take here. So it will give the value of, so let me see, 69,000 multiplied into 25 into 2 divided by 12, so that will give the 2,87,500. Directly I am going to write in the outer column. Next one, production in progress or work in progress. Okay, that is taken as the same 69,000 units multiplied into, so the unit cost is 40. Okay, so here I will just write refer working note 1 to take this value. How we took the that value and why we took the that value. Okay, next one. So what is the credit period for the that given process, that is production process has the 1 month credit period. So that will give you the answer as 69,000 multiplied into 40 multiplied into 1 divided by 12 will give the 2,30,000 as the production process price. So here I am going to write in the inner column, because we need to take the finished goods also. Finished goods nu na thogobekala adakke adanna hange idana. Next one, finished goods is having the again the same units 69,000 into 40 rupees. Again you can refer for working note number 1, how we got the 40. So multiplied with, so what is the credit period they have given? 3 months. 3 months divided by 12. So I will get the value as 6,90,000. 6,90,000. Okay. So we'll add the both the value and I got 9,20,000 in the both the work in progress and finished goods. Now I will move on to the debtors. Okay, so the debtors is also have the same, right? Okay, how the work in progress took and the finished goods took. So the same price again I am going to quote as the 40 rupees only. So this 40 rupees also taken in case of the debtors, because it also have the raw material, wages and the overhead. Okay, let me take the same amount, that is 69,000 multiplied into 40. So multiplied by, what is the credit period that given to debtors is the 3 months. So directly they have given in the question that, so it is considered for the debtors. So that is 6,90,000. Similarly, so we'll take the all the calculations and now we'll add the value. Okay, one by one let us add. 2,87,500 plus 9,20,000 plus 6,90,000, all together I got the 18,97,500. Okay, so this 18,97,500 is the total current assets. Okay, now I am going to less the current liabilities, that is creditors. Under the creditors we have the only 2 amounts, that is raw materials and wages paid. Okay, any other information they didn't given. Okay, so the raw material based on your credit purchases, right? So here are they have given any as the cash is taken? So no, it is not given, right? The same I am going to take as the my value as the raw materials. So that is 69,000 of units. So multiplied by the raw materials, how much the price? It is 25. So the credit period is given for the creditors is 2 months. So divided by 12. So I will get the value as 2,87,500. So already I calculated the same amount, the same I have took here. Now we will see the wages paid. Okay, wages paid is having the only and only amount that is taken as the labor cost. So what is the labor cost here? It is rupees 5. The same is taken here. Okay, let me see. 69,000 multiplied into, so what is the labor cost? It is 5. Multiplied by, so what is the credit period they have given to laborers? It is for the it is here. Okay, you can see the wages are paid in the next month of accrual, means one period is given for the credit. Okay, so here is the our clue. So what is the credit period? Means it is 1 month. 1 divided by 12. So we will get the answer as 28,750. So I will add this 1. So I got 3,16,250. So we will just deduct the current liabilities in the current assets. 18,97,500 minus 316,250. So I got 15,81,250 as the my working capital. So required with the this problem. So hope you understood the problem. So it is very easy and some tricky is there. So if you have taken the same steps as we calculated in the previous step, so it may give you the more time and the more wastage of the your time. So that's why, so I have cut shorted the your steps into one step. So hope you understood this adjustment.